Well, I'm Bob Schieffer, and I came to CBS in 1969, literally walked in off the street. I tried for 5 years to get a job at CBS News, and I could never get an appointment. So I had made my way to Washington from Texas and was working at one of the local stations, and I decided that I didn't like that job very much, and that if I couldn't get a job at CBS, I was going back to Texas. So I walked over without an appointment. Walked in, went to the second floor, asked to see the bureau chief. I said, I'm Bob Schieffer. I've come to see Bill Small about a job. And the woman said, yes, Bob, come right in. And I was ushered in, and as a result of that interview, was hired. And it was not until sometime later that I figured out what had happened. I had walked in on another person's appointment, and the person was Bob Hager. And some years ago, I called Bob on the phone and I said, I want to ask you something. I said, in the spring of 1969, did you have an appointment with Bill Small to talk about a job? And he said, yeah, that's when it was. But he said, you know, nothing ever came of it. So he said, NBC offered me a job and I went to work there. Well, Bob Hager had a long and distinguished career, retired last year. And I guess CBS just hired they thought they were hiring someone else. I guess I'm the only person they ever hired by mistake. But that is the true story of how I came to work at CBS News. Walked in on somebody else's appointment. My first beat after I was there for a while was the Pentagon. I loved it. I was there for 5 years. From there, I went to the White House and covered the White House when President Ford became president after Nixon resigned. Covered 2 years of Jimmy Carter, then went to New York to be the anchor, an episode best forgotten in my career, of the CBS Morning News. It was a total disaster. I didn't know how to do it. And when they picked when Walter Cronkite retired and they picked Dan Rather to take his place on the evening news, I asked if I could just come back to Washington, and I did, and I lived happily ever after. And in 1991, after covering all the major beats in Washington, the Pentagon, the White House, the State Department, and Capitol Hill, they asked me to anchor Face the Nation, which is the best job in television. I mean, if you're a reporter and you like the news, I mean, what can be better than having the newsmakers come to you? You don't even have to come to them. And so I've had a really happy time here doing this job. It's the best job I ever had. And I started to retire a couple of times, but every time I do, something always happens and I don't. So I've just sort of given up on that. I'm just going to keep doing this for a while. Well, somebody asked me if there was anything that I would do if I was guaranteed that I would not fail. And I said, well, yeah, Gweneth Paltrow. But I hope Gweneth Paltrow knows that's just a joke. But she's terrific. I met her last year at the Country Music Association Awards. She sang there, and we actually got our picture taken together. She's a very sweet young woman.